You're watching today. Current COVID-19 restrictions in New South Wales are likely to last more than 5 days as the state's cluster grows to 11 cases.
New South Wales AMA President Dr. Danielle McMullen joins us in the studio. Nice to see you, Doctor.
Good morning.
I just get this feeling that Sydney isn't taking this latest outbreak quite seriously enough.
Yeah, I haven't. I agree. I don't think the vibe has changed in Sydney enough to reflect the serious outbreak situation that we're in. I do think that people do need to be more concerned than they seem to be at the moment.
That being said, it's only 2 cases and they're already in isolation.
True, but what we've seen over the past few days is that relatively fleeting contact has led to transmission events. Now, it's fantastic that people are obviously looking at the list on New South Wales Health site. They're already self-isolating, so the last few cases have already been in isolation. But we really need to see testing numbers go up and we need to make sure that we have mopped up this whole cluster so that we don't end up in a situation like some other states.
When you look at the number of exposure sites, right, and you know how virulent this is, this particular strain, how do we not have dozens of people with it?
Yeah, look, I think people have been really good at following the advice and we need to do more testing to make sure we don't have dozens of cases. But also COVID's such a bizarre illness. Sometimes it seems to transmit really easily and then other people you think should have contracted it haven't. We don't have a great explanation for that, but we do need to be on the lookout.
Where do you think this sort of sense of complacency has come from? And testing numbers, I think on Sunday, 25,000. And what would you like to see that number at?
Look, I think we've been a bit the enemy of our own success. New South Wales has been fantastic at managing outbreaks in the past and we should and will again, but we need to maintain that vigour of following public health advice. And I certainly think we need to increase our testing numbers at least above 30,000, but look, 40 or 50,000 a day would be great.
Do you think it's getting to the point where, Gladys Berejiklian has been incredibly strong, do you think it's getting to the point where she does need to do a bordered lockdown of East Sydney?
Look, I think to date, as you said, the last couple of cases were already in isolation. It shows our contact tracing is working.
Yeah.
But the next few days will tell. We certainly need to get testing numbers up. And if that doesn't happen and we start to see more cases creeping around, then I think harder measures will come in.
Do you think that the restrictions we currently have in place, considering the numbers, are adequate?
I think mask wearing is really important at the moment and there's some confusion about which local government area. So really the message across Sydney is if you're out indoors and can't physically distance, put on a mask.
You'd be keeping your eye on Queensland as well, north of the border. That was one case so far through hotel quarantine, we believe, again, and surface contact. It's how easily it can get out.
It can. This virus is pretty sneaky. It's very what we call virulent. It's easy to catch. So we really need to maintain vigilance. I know we're all exhausted. It's been a long 18 months, but when we can't rest just yet. We've all got to get our vaccines and gradually roll towards more normal.
Which is all fine if there was enough, but there is not enough vaccines. You've got a whole bunch of people now, everyone up to the age of 60 who wants Pfizer, who can't get it.
Yeah, look, we've got the over 60s, there's ample supply. So, look, if you're over 60 and can come and get an AstraZeneca, we've got appointments available. And Pfizer clinics are increasing. I know there's been a bit of a challenge getting some this past week or so, but supplies are supposed to increase and we're putting pressure on government to get that happening quicker.
GPs, the pressure will certainly fall on them too as we get more Pfizers in. And then 50,000 for New South Wales as well. Similar amounts going out to other states, but GPs, the pressure will fall on them. Are they ready for that?
Yeah, look, we're ready for another vaccine program. We deliver a whole lot of vaccines through general practice and Pfizer should be arriving in our doors over the coming months, but it will be a staged rollout, so some patience is needed.
Do you feel a bit sorry for the people over the age of 60 who are stuck with AstraZeneca? Because, I mean, the efficacy is less than Pfizer. They're the ones who are most at risk. Well, that's probably more the over 70s. But it's a bit unfair that we're sort of saying to them, you've got to have this.
Look, they're both very good vaccines and the efficacy that we're seeing in real-world data is encouraging for both. I had an AstraZeneca vaccine and nowhere near 60. But look, they are good vaccines. At the moment, it's what we've got available. And we know that if you're over 60, particularly over 70, your risk of severe illness or death from COVID is much higher. So it's so important to get the vaccine that's available at the moment.
By the time we roll out the first lot and the second lot, we'll be ready for the booster.
That's it. And it won't be long before we're next year and we're ready for a booster, and probably those will be all the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines.
Get used to the needles. Mm-hmm. All right, good to talk to you. Thank you.
Well, the Bondi COVID cluster has grown again by two, with Premier Gladys Berejiklian warning mask rules will likely extend beyond Wednesday, but stopping short of tightening restrictions for now. Joining me is infectious diseases expert Professor Robert Boy in Sydney. Professor, thanks for your time. Should restrictions go further? Yeah.
I think they're taking a very effective approach right now. We're only getting one or two cases per day, and they're in isolation. So it's working, and it shows that with a nuanced public health approach, working hand in glove with the general public, you can get control of this without a lockdown.
So does that mean the restrictions are working, or is it just that we're not having enough people coming forward to be tested?
Oh, there are 10,000 people tested for every case found. The public is doing a great job. We're finding the cases, but remember, this started with just one case. So just one case out there that's undiscovered could lead to further outbreaks and chains of transmission. So that's why it's really important for people to come forward. I myself have done it four times and have had minimal symptoms. It's just play safe.
What seems to be the real issue with this Delta variant is how fleeting contact can be to pass on COVID.
Yes, it has been fleeting exposures. They've looked on closed circuit cameras. They've looked at QR codes. And might I just emphasise that QR codes are so important. Even if you're going into a shop for 1 or 2 minutes to order a takeaway, you could make a difference to yourself and to the people that you associating with in shopping centres and cinemas. QR codes have not been emphasised enough. Do it when you go in and do it when you go out.
Considering how easy it is to contract this particular variant, do you think that we do have COVID within the community that we're not aware of, not included in those numbers?
Look, it's possible. Most people are not super transmitters. Most people transmit very little. But we don't know who will be, so there could still be a case out there that could be found. My confidence is more on the control side than it is on the scary side.
I just want to talk about the vaccine rollout, because we heard yesterday that the 22 Commonwealth vaccination centres which administer Pfizer, they're going to increase to 70 in July. I would have thought that would be a problem, because we've got every state saying at the moment they don't have enough.
Yes, we do need more supply. If we're going to vaccinate 1 million people a week, that's a lot more doses than we're currently delivering. Based on figures I've seen, we're delivering less than 500,000 per week. If we're going to get to Christmas with a vaccinated population, there's only 26 vaccinating weeks to Christmas. 1 million a week is enough for only 13 million people at two doses each. We need to be doing better and continuing the acceleration and the opening up.
Do you think we'll meet that target by Christmas?
We won't meet a 100% target, but we never were aiming for that. We could get to 75% with an ongoing, sustained effort.
All right, 75% by Christmas. We'll take those odds. Professor, thanks for joining us this morning. Appreciate it.